matter. It's a matter of picking and choosing our shots and stopping number 13. We got to stop 13.
Running Eagles win the tip. Austin Kuntz on a near side wing. Wader finds Myers on the far side. Now Moran at the top of the key. Tyler Moran. He's got C.J. Mann on him.
Coach's kid. Girls coach's kid.
Myers, mid-round, finds Tyler Moran for three, who got blocked. Rebound, Wader put it up
that?
And in from the baseline.
Did you see him scoop that up off
I
the floor?
I saw that. Arvidas.
23, D.J. George has it on the baseline. Pass poked away and picked up by Austin Myers. He got poked and picked.
Great deflection by Wader right there, too, to force the steal.
Wader gets it outside to Moran. Moran head fakes, drives, pulls up from the baseline, and gets it to go. Mid-range jumper for Tyler Moran.
Austin Wader's got more stats in 30 seconds than I've ever seen. 2 points, one rebound, a deflection, and an assist right there.
I'm telling you.
Well done.
Austin Kluck on the far side finds Dax Staler. Kluck from the free throw line.
Nice day.
Yep. Don't lose 13. We got to know where he's at. There he is. Let him have that.
Kluck pulls up off the back of the iron. No good. Eagles on the break. Kuntz goes up. Can't get it to fall.
Gosh.
And they'll call a charge.
God, looks like he slid in there late. Great job by Austin. Attacking the rim. Trying to finish at the front of the rim. Yep. Well done. I like that.
Well, teams know by now that he's going to go to the rim.
Oh, yeah.
And if you can get there first, you can definitely slow him down. But he's got to recognize that as well, be able to give it up.
Number 13, C.J. Mann handling the ball. He finds D.J. George. Mann for three, far side corner, and it's going to fall for the Alma Airedales.
He's a shooter.
You got to be in his face. I mean, you can't give him any room at all. Zero room.
Myers to Wader, top of the key. Now Landon Hill. Wader to Moran. Moran driving far side. Finds Myers. Myers driving, floats it up. No good. But he was fouled. He's going to go to the line to shoot two.
Double zero.
Yeah. Good strong move by Myers there to take it to the hole and get a couple of shots here.
Austin Myers, the man with the tan at the free throw line. First free throw up and good for Myers. Both free throws fall for Myers. Eagles are up 6-3. D.J. George finds Staler on the far side, and Staler lost the ball out of bounds. It's Eagle basketball. Coach Jeremy Simon wearing a pretty nice shirt there.
Absolutely.
He's in jogging pants in the JV game.
That shirt is slightly nicer than Chris Lee's.
Was it jogging suit tearaway? I mean, he just, after the announcements and the starting lineups, did he just rip it off and that was on? I missed all that.
May have been.
That's how you do it. We'll give and go.
Kluck.
Good D.
Couldn't get it up.
Yeah, too many bodies in there that are just too tall. They're going to have to shoot it from the outside. That's how they're going to have to stay.
Landon Hill to Kuntz. Kuntz stops the key, driving, dishes right back out to Hill. Landon Hill to Kuntz. Kuntz head fakes, drives, goes up, no good. Rebound, Wader.
Wader in. Wader with another rebound. Whoa.
Oh, they'll call a foul on Wader. Positioning foul on Austin Wader.
About that.
Oh, tough break right there. I didn't see that one, guys.
Rick Heffington is watching AK from Jamaica. Joyce Birkin is watching Austin Kuntz from Wisconsin.
That's AK's family. That's awesome. He's got a fan club that stretches about a couple thousand miles right there, huh?
At least two.
Yeah.
C.J. Mann pulls up his pass, picked off by Tyler Moran. Moran on the break now for the Eagles. And Tyler Moran draws a foul from number 13, C.J. Mann.
That's a bad foul by C.J. Mann.
Yeah,
and a
little
good
frustration
foul for
out
us.
There, yeah.
Myers at the top of the key will give right back to Landon Hill. Hill to Kuntz Austin Kuntz top the key to Landon Hill near side. Now Wader. Moran handling the ball on the baseline. Turns around, puts it up, and good from the mid-range.
Nice shot.
So man's not tall enough to elevate to his level to block that or even get a hand in his face. So that's there all night for Moran.
Absolutely.
I think they're seeing that.
Dax Taylor couldn't pull that pass in.
They can hopefully get him down there on that baseline and isolate him one-on-one.
Yeah. Oh, nice back door.
Moran puts it up no good, but he was fouled. He's going to go to the line to shoot too.
Nice little set play from Coach Simon right there. Backdoor screen. Coach Flanor got his palms up, questioning his entire team. Like, what are y'all doing?
Tyler Moran, big week. Signed with UCA. Play football. Hopefully get a big win here tonight.
No doubt.
First free throw no good for Tyler Moran.
Now they got a little hot coming in to counter Wader.
A lot of folks don't know this about Coach Flanor, and really Alma program. You know, 04-05, girls and boys both won state in basketball.
Wow.
Pretty big deal. So he's been there, done that. Second one up and in.
Tyler Moran goes 1-for-2 from the free throw line that time. Scores 3-9. Again, we are in Alma. One of the best arenas in the state of Arkansas. DJ George on the drive. Gets out to 24, Nathan Whalen. That's number 20, Devin Wood puts it up and in. Tyler Moran on the near side gets a screen from Wader. Moran driving, finds Landon Hill for three, far side wing, and it's going to go for Landon Hill.
He was backing up as soon as he left his hands. He knew it was
good.
Yeah. Like the intensity right there by Kuntz.
CJ Mann working on Moran. His pass to Staler. That shot was up no good for three from Dax Staler, and they'll call a blocking foul on Austin Wader.
That's two.
You know, that's one thing, though. We did not we didn't block out. I mean, when he left his hand on the three-pointer, we should have followed the ball to the basket, and we started going down court, and he got his own rebound off the long rebound, or the long miss.
Tough break for Wader right there. It's two quick ones. CJ.
That deep three up and good for CJ Mann.
You cannot let him have the ball. I mean, you can let him have the ball, but you need to be in
his
back pocket.
Absolutely. Yeah. Man to man from Alma right here. Coach Simon bringing the play in.
Austin Myers to Kuntz down low. Austin Kuntz loses the ball. Tried to save it. It was picked up by Staler. Now CJ Mann's on the break. Mann finds DJ George, who gets to number 20, Devin Wood. Staler for three, near side wing, no good. Rebound.
That ball landed completely out of bounds. No call. Wow.
That was out of bounds.
They'll call it out on DJ George on the far side.
And, guys, we talked about it earlier. I mean, Kuntz is going to get the double and triple teams. He's got to recognize that.
He
didn't recognize it or it was too late.
He had Braden open on the perimeter.
I think the headband
threw him off. He saw Braden with the headband. He didn't know what to do.
Cobra Kai.
Cobra Kai. Sweep the leg, Johnny. Here we go. Looks like a zone, but it's still man-to-man.
Braden Lee pulls up for three, far side, no good. Rebound.
Great hustle.
Same team fighting for the rebound. Costs him. It's the legal basketball. Moran on the drive, pulls up. And good. Tyler Moran is unconscious.
Yeah, he can hang in the air for so long. They don't have anything for him.
DJ George works around, gives number 20 Devin Wood. Wood finds Whalen. Now it's George on the drive. DJ George high off the glass, no good. Rebound Whalen. Stolen away by Moran. Tyler Moran is going to slow it down for the Eagles.
And guys, we went into that man-to-man defense, right?
Yep.
We weren't into man, but it seems like we were in man that time.
Braden Lee, far side corner, pulls up for three, no good. Rebound.
A good tip out by AK.
Landon Hill. Landon Hill finds Myers near side corner. Myers gets it to go.
Myers says, Lee, let me show you how to do it. This is how you make
Austin
that one.
Austin Myers for three.
Hey, they were both good shots, though. Good open looks.
CJ Mann.
Back to the zone.
That's number 15, Martin Dyer.
Oh, it's going to hurt us.
C.J. Mann throws up a three, and it's going to go from the top of the key for C.J. Mann.
He doesn't miss, man. He's 3 for 3.
He'll keep shooting, too. Make or miss. He has no conscience.
Yep.
Now, the student section for Alma, while they do seem loud, it's just because this place is so big.
Yeah.
There's only about maybe 20 kids in the student section. Maybe.
Hey, Kay, thought about it. Yeah, this is the matchup right here, like you're saying, Sam. Keep attacking.
Braden Lee for three. Top of the key, no good. Myers nearly got the rebound, and so it's going to go out of bounds. Last touch to Austin Myers.
Hey, I like, Braden's getting some good looks. He's definitely gotten three great looks on the outside. And
layups and free throws now, though.
C.J. Mann handling the ball for the Airedales. He's going to pull up for three. Air ball.
Good box
bounces
out.
Bounces out of bounds.
40 seconds to go. Set us something up here. Maybe one final shot, or I'm not sure.
This first quarter's flown by.
Has.
Absolutely. 35 seconds left in the first quarter. Landon Hill near side, fakes the pass, finds Braden Lee, top of the key. Landon Hill to Myers, near side corner for Myers, no good. Rebound Braden Lee.
Yeah, he tried to call timeout. They gave him the timeout. Great hustle.
Yeah, good hustle right there.
Great hustle there by Cobra Kai, number one. He went down, Johnny, for the leg sweep, and he found a ball laying there.
He got it.
Chris.
Yes, sir.
What's up with the headband? First time we saw that this year.
Yeah, you know, he's growing his bangs out.
It's probably sweat because we don't have his dad sweats up here. So.
That is true. That is definitely
full
the
truth. Full body sweat.
Full body sweat.
Did,
give a shout-out to our conference game sponsor tonight, Linda Marie's, featuring Charlie's Corner. Got a 75% sale going on all day tomorrow over there at the Bypass and South Mount Olive there in Bologna.
I can't even think
straight. Big shout-out to all of our sponsors. But our conference game sponsor tonight is Linda Marie's.
Oh, it took me like a minute to get that up.
And actually, I think I have to tell on myself, tonight was Bologna Family Pharmacy. Linda Marie's is BB, so we're going to have to flip-flop those.
Okay,
so
that's
100% blame on myself. We'll work it out.
No biggie.
We'll work it out.
Braden Lee.
Both of them are great sponsors.
Moran gets it poked away by Mann. C.J. Mann on the break, laces it up and in.
C.J.
Tyler Moran, 8 seconds to work with, scores 13-17 with 4 seconds.
You know he wants
Moran driving, goes up.
They'll call
a travel on Tyler Moran with 1.9 seconds left.
I like the idea, though, attacking the basket. That would have been two on C.J. if they had called it.
Where was the
C.J. Mann forced the dribble around a little bit too much, and that's the end of the first quarter. Bologna Eagles up against the Alma Airedales, 17-13. We'll go ahead and take this break to talk a little bit about our conference sponsors.
Yep, absolutely. Conference game sponsor tonight, as we just mentioned, Linda Marie's. But also, too, we have a lot of other platinum sponsors. The Bologna Eagle Basketball Foundation is very lucky to have platinum sponsors like Sims Electric, Bologna Family Pharmacy, Gen Wealth Financial Advisors, Mr. Chad Roller, Luke Gordon at Ott Insurance, Central Arkansas Trophy, HSA Engineering, and, of course, a conference game sponsor tonight, Linda Marie's. 75% sale going on tomorrow. And if you want to know more about it, just ask Sam and his socks.
Man,
his
tell
wife
you what,
got some socks there.
I got some great socks. I think most people in the Bologna area would love my socks.
Yeah, and your shoes are off right now. They don't smell that bad.
Hey.
Those socks must have like some aromatique powers or something.
You know what? I was so proud of these socks the other day, especially with just a crazy week, you know, in our nation. I wore these socks to the gym, and I got quite a few compliments on my socks.
Sandals? Socks and sandals?
No, I wore these socks with my workout shoes. And
did you have some of the old school bike coaching shorts with the two snaps up top? That's my boy. That's my boy right there. Graham don't know anything about that. All right, here we go.
I went with my half shirt on, half with the netted see-through.
Oh, man. I just heard Bon Jovi playing in the background.
C.J. Mann poked away by Landon Hill. Landon Hill's on the break with Graham Middleton. Middleton's got it now. He lays it up and in off the glass. Two more points for the Bologna Eagles.
Great move there.
C.J. Mann handling the ball for Alma now. Man gets to number three, Austin Cluck, who's going to drive, get blocked by Middleton.
Oh, gosh.
Wait, and they'll call a foul on Graham Middleton. They're going to say he got his arm in there after swatting for the ball.
Kind of a late whistle right there.
Yeah, it was. I thought he was waiting for the ball to go out of bounds to call it out of bounds, and it didn't go out of bounds. He's like, I got to call a foul.
Yeah.
Cluck's first free throw up and good. 19-14.
Austin Waiters having Wilson check something out over there. He may have a little blood on his. Waiters got two fouls. He's out right now, so he's addressing. Hopefully he's all right. Got a ball game here, guys.
Austin Kuntz to Landon Hill on the far side wing. Now Middleton top of the key for three. Grant Middleton gets it to go for three.
That looked so fluid when it left his hand. And he had a great JV game, so I'm sure coach was like, I know you're going to shoot well tonight.
CJ Mann pulls up for three, far side wing, bouncing around, no good. Rebound Middleton.
How about Graham on the rebound?
Tyler Moran handling the ball for the Eagles, gets to Landon Hill, back to Moran, top of the key.
Graham wants it. He's asking for it. He wants it.
Graham Middleton near side wing.
Nice look.
To Myers near corner. Kuntz down low, spinning, loses it. Picked up by number zero, Dax Staler.
One too many spin moves, I believe, right there. Cost
him. He had him early.
He had him in the first part, and he had a one-on-one, which was great.
Staler's pass picked off by Moran. Now Kuntz trying to save it. Didn't get there in time. Pass a little bit too far from Moran.
We need to call him for deflections. Austin Kuntz forced the steal. Timo gets the steal. Is that like a sack in the NFL? They get like a .5, they get a half?
Yeah. I don't believe so.
No.
That would be awesome, but... Probably makes your job a little bit easier, Chris.
Yeah, absolutely.
CJ Mann goes up.
Good D.
Shot altered by Tyler Moran. Couldn't tell if he blocked it or not, but he's making a great move on the break. Puts it up and in.
What a play.
Tyler Moran with one of the best plays he's had so far this season.
Yeah. Coast to coast.
His jump shot is like not like a lot of kids. I mean, he elevates so well. He can hang in the air.
He does.
Everybody else is still down on the ground, you know, and
he's still hanging. Hang time.
Yeah. Levitates up there, you know.
Yep. 30-second timeout here. Big shout out to our conference game sponsor of the night, Linda Marie's. Like we've talked about in the previous game, mentioned it just a second ago, 75% sale. I think they have a sale room, a clearance room.
Yeah.
Has anybody seen it?
I have not.
That's
but it
impressive.
Looks nice.
I saw the picture that Steve sent me from the Facebookogram, wherever that came from. It looked impressive. You better get there early, though. It's going to be standing room only.
That's right.
Could be aggressive.
Limited parking.
Limited, yeah.
6 minutes, 14 seconds left to go in the second quarter. Eagles up 24-15. CJ Mann will give the number five, Bobby Winfrey. Mann again on the near side. The Staler. Staler driving, gets past Myers, goes up and lays it in. Gets by the Eagle defense.
Not sure how he got through all three of those guys without getting it blocked.
Yeah, somebody might run for that at practice.
Tyler Moran handling the ball, gets Landon Hill far side wing. Now Moran, head fake, finds Myers, couldn't corral the pass quite cleanly. Myers to Moran. Moran driving, goes up, loses it.
Yeah, Tyler's thinking like we are. Like surely that was a foul.
Yeah.
Moran, top of the key, working on CJ Mann. Hand to Landon Hill. Landon Hill driving, give to Middleton. Grant Middleton loses the ball. DJ George on the drive now. DJ George goes up and got blocked off the backboard by Tyler Moran.
What a block.
That was a great block.
What a block by Tyler Moran as that ball goes out of bounds. Coach Stan Flinner wants a goaltending.
I thought he blocked it before it hit the backboard, did he not?
Coach Flinner, he is wound livid. Tight.
I guess I missed it. Well, we're looking at it now on replay.
I mean, his hair, I've never seen it move in the 3 years I've called these games. It is actually out of place. He's upset. I didn't see it, guys. I was keeping stats.
CJ Mann on the drive, puts it up and in for two.
I'm pretty sure that was a whole bottle of Aquanet, too.
Just the good stuff. Aquanet Premium.
Aquanet and nothing like a little, I can't even think of the name. No, the cologne.
Oh, Cool Water. What else?
Cool Water.
Austin Kuntz going up,
right there.
Lost the ball. It's going to go out of bounds. It's illegal basketball.
You know, Valonia's got 14 fouls. Alma's got three. You know, they're letting them play, guys. We're 4 minutes out from halftime. Physical ball game.
Austin Koontz at the top of the key. We'll give to Landon Hill on the near side wing. Landon Hill, pump fake, driving, gets it up to Myers. Myers down low, up and in, and they'll call a travel on Austin Myers.
I don't know how that was a travel, guys. His feet, he never left the ground. What's the ref looking at? And even Simon just kind of threw his hands up like, what do you mean?
That shot up, no good. Oh. Rebound Austin Koontz.
Cinder block.
The hair is stressed from the live fan feedback. You know, Coach Stan Flinter nice probably cut. Does have the best hair in the 5A West.
Oh, he's a great coach. You know, we're being silly up here, but nice back. Man,
what a shot
fire.
By Tyler Moran.
You can't stop him. You only can hope to contain him.
Just hope. You can just hope. I think Coach Flinter has two or three rings, so no disrespect by any means.
Bobby Winfrey for three up. No good. Rebound, Moran.
Timo.
Austin Myers was in there, but Moran wanted that rebound.
Talking about building some houses.
Koontz, top of the key. We'll give it to the far side. Hill. Now Moran inside. Who gets it to go? Tyler Moran.
It's his night, guys. He's got 13 in the first half.
Drop 30 on this young man.
CJ Mann working on Tyler Moran. He'll give to DJ George on the far side. Now it's Bobby Winfrey. Austin Kluck pulls up for three, top of the key. No good. Rebound Koontz.
Nice board.
Tyler Moran now.
Thing is, poor, you know, Austin doing some great things, but he has no points, guys, yet to be.
Yep.
No points in the game.
Yeah, he's smart, though. Senior leader right here doing all the little things. Let the game come to him. Don't force it. Good catch. Look at here.
That shot up, no good for Moran.
He forced that one.
Rebound gets bobbled around, eventually picked up by C.J. Mann. Mann finds D.J. George, is going to drive along the baseline, put it up and in for two.
Coach Simon, good timeout right there. D.J. George, that's like a quarterback name or maybe a NASCAR name or something. That just has a ring to it, D.J. George.
Guys, you know, talking about Tyler Moran, we talked about it on his signing Wednesday, being a multiple sport athlete.
Yep.
You think maybe UCA, seeing him play a little bit of basketball there?
I could see him maybe doing
maybe
some
so.
Track, maybe some track with the football. You know, continue to work on his speed. He's a hurdler. You know, he's got a great chance to win the 5A this year as a, what is he, a 300-meter hurdler, I believe. So, he's got a great chance to win another couple of rings. I mean, indoor and outdoor track should win state unless something crazy happens. They're just that good.
Well,
this year.
Outdoor could be
it'll be
a challenge.
It'll be more of a challenge, but we've got some unbelievable mid-distance.
Oh yes, absolutely.
I'm gonna say it right now on the air. I mean, the 800 meters will win the state championship for Bologna, just like last year when they came in 1, 2, and 3 in the 800.
Wow. That was at Lake Hamilton last year, wasn't it?
It was.
That was impressive.
They shocked some people with that because those 1, 2, and 3 was not supposed to be anywhere near 1, 2, and 3. I think the Lake Hamilton kid was supposed to win it. He came in fourth. Bologna just said, hey, I'm staying with you. No, I'm staying with you. We're all going to stay with you. We're going to push each other till the end. It was great.
Tyler Moran with the basketball for the Bologna Eagles. Middleton, near side corner, gets to Moran. Now Koontz top of the key. Koontz driving. Went up, had 1 foot on the ground still. Pivots around. Finds Austin Myers. Everybody on the Alma side wanted a travel call. Don't get it.
That might be a makeup call for Austin Myers. That never happened last time down.
Myers pulls up for three. It will fall, but they'll call a foul elsewhere. They'll give it to number 5, Bobby Winfrey.
Good minutes from Graham right there.
Oh, yeah, had a rebound, had a three-pointer, had some good defense.
Myers, near side corners, a foul is called against the Eagles.
He called that on Waiter. Waiter got a foul in a Mississippi. Wasn't even a full second. What was the call?
Well, what happened was Waiter got sandwiched between, it looks like, Koontz,
right
and an
in.
Alma guy, yeah, an Alma defender, and just got tripped up.
Yeah, that's
sometimes those nights happen. You got to be smart right here, not get his fourth.
Yeah, that's three.
DJ George gives to Mann,
and
Mann lost the ball, then drove, ran into Austin Koontz, and that's going to be a foul on Austin Koontz.
That's two on AK.
Referee's getting a little bit touchy now. I didn't like all the yelling from the Alma side.
Coach Simon's like, I wore this shirt, and you're calling like this. I can't take it. I don't blame him.
Dax Taylor gets it inside to Waylon. He threw it off the bottom of the rim. Winfrey got C.J. Mann. Waylon down low to Winfrey. Bobby Winfrey loses it. Pass picked off by Tyler Moran.
He was out of bounds. His foot was out of bounds as well. I mean, I don't know what these refs are looking at. They're not looking at feet, I promise you.
Tyler Moran handling the ball. They'll call a block on D.J. George.
Alma faithful living.
Team up.
There's nothing wrong with that call. Eagle fans happy.
No.
You can't run into the ball handler, then jump back and expect to get a charge call. I'm sorry.
I think that's 23's mom sitting right next to us, Graham. She's giving you that stink eye right now.
Oh, no, guys. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
It's been nice knowing you.
Tyler Moran handling the ball against DJ George. Moran driving by him, finds Myers. Far corner three, Austin Myers, no good.
Oh,
rebound. Landon Hill gets it to Myers. Myers puts it up again. No good. Moran looks like he got fouled from behind by number 20, Devin Wood.
Heads up play by LT right there.
How about that?
I'm giving him an offensive rebound for that tip back over to Myers to keep the play alive.
They were thinking we're going to the other end to make a quick play up.
He came out of nowhere. The haymaker tipped it back to 32, Myers somehow. 1-1.
They're going two shots. They're saying he was tipping it back in when he got fouled because we're at six. So they're calling that as a tip.
Oh, he's shooting too. Okay.
He was tipping it back in when he got fouled from behind.
Hey, we'll take that.
Tyler Moran, first free throw up and good.
AK's got – I got him down for two right here. He's taking a quick breather.
Yeah, don't want to get a
– Board has him just at one.
You
though.
Don't want to get a cheap foul here right before half.
C.J. Mann gets the rebound from the second free throw.
Man-to-man from the Eagles.
Mann up over Moran, gets it to go.
I mean,
what a shot from C.J. Mann.
What do you do on that? I mean
– How does he do that?
He was in his face.
I think as he jumps, you have to lunge – at his midsection, not.
You can't block him up. I see what you're saying. You got stripping.
Yeah.
Excellent basketball mind, Chris. Braden Lee handling the ball for the Eagles with 35 seconds left in the first half.
From Simon bringing the play in here.
Well, he's thinking, let's get a good shot. Let's don't give them another chance to get any closer. He'll make some great adjustments as always at halftime, and we'll
absolutely.
Come out and.
That's his specialty.
Yeah.
Timo's got the matchup right here we like to see exploited.
15 seconds. 29-24, Tyler Moran handling the ball. 10 seconds now.
Where's the ball screen?
Moran working on Staler, gets by him, finds Braden Lee for three, far side wing, and it's going to go for Braden Lee.
Big time by Lee.
And that's the end of the first half. Braden Lee got the three-pointer to go. Eagles up 32-24 at the end of one half.
That'll make a daddy proud. Right
absolutely,
there.
Chris. Is that how you drew it up there?
I was sitting here drawing it up
in the driveway.
Yep, that's what he did to me on 2K the other night when he beat me by 40.
Oh wow!
So yeah, that's a long story.
Yeah,
but I got him on mad the next night. Yeah, way to finish the half right there, guys. And as we go into the break, let's give another special thank you to our conference game sponsor of the night. Linda Marie's featuring Charlie's Corner. Guys, listen, if you're in the area tomorrow, 75% off. They have a whole room dedicated to this sale going on, so definitely go check it out. So proud to have the Weavers sponsoring the Bologna Eagle Basketball Foundation broadcast, but they do so much for the entire community, football, basketball, all the sports, all the organizations. Big shout-out to them tonight.
Yeah. We wouldn't have half the stuff we have right now if it wasn't for Linda Marie's.
That's so true.
Yep. They, at the first of the year, they donate $4,000.
Wow.
Just to Eagle Vision.
Yeah.
And we were able to, you know, upgrade our equipment and stuff. So, man.
And the scoreboard and the field and
this,
you know, basketball side of the house.
They do
too,
so much for Bologna sports and the community as a whole.
Hey, guys, we're going to take a quick break, and we will be back with a little analysis right before the end of the half.
Here's my confession, I've got a death wish. I'm in the fast lane, addicted to excess. Living my best life, I was on top right. Sipping the limelight, a deer in the headlights. My future used to shine as bright as the diamond. Where did time go? I was so high, it was private. No, I'm messed up, but there's no use in crying. No use in crying. I've been running wild, had a good time, but I can't stop now. Over my head in a landslide, can you pull me out? Oh my dear Lord.
Almost ready for some more basketball action. Got rid of the music right there.
Yeah, I was going to let you talk and sing along slash talk to the music.
Hey, we're getting ready for the third quarter. I'm Grant McNew alongside Chris Lee, Sam Jansky, and Stone Cold Steve Austin. Right now, the Valonia boys are up 32-24 over the Alma Airedales. It's been an exciting one so far tonight. We hope that continues into the second half.
You know, something Sam brought up that, you know, we really didn't talk much about, but, you know, AK not having any points. Moran has 13, 14 points in the first half, but AK did all these different little things that added up. Let's see how the second half goes.
Yep.
Tyler Moran handling the ball for the Eagles.
Man to man.
He has 14 points. Landon Hill near side wing to Koontz. Koontz pulls up for three, far side wing, no good. Rebound, CJ Mann on the break. Man gets it over to Bobby Winfrey, who can't get it to go. Rebound Austin Myers.
Yeah, they fought each other for that one.
Yeah, that was hard to watch.
Landon Hill for the Eagles.
Coach Simon bringing a play in and setting something up.
Austin Koontz, far side wing, gets to Hill, top of the key. Now Myers on the near side.
Oh, I like it.
Graham Middleton to Landon Hill, far side. Landon Hill on the drive, gets it up and good.
Good that? Strong drive, man.
Very
wow.
Good drive. I didn't know if he had the angle there.
Yeah.
CJ Mann working on Tyler Moran.
He's high point on the floor. Got 16.
CJ Mann pulls up for two, bouncing all around and finally falls.
Shooter's roll right there. I got to stroke it.
Koontz near side, dribbling around. Finds Landon Hill back out. Now Tyler Moran, top of the key. Graham Middleton to Landon Hill. Now Koontz on the far side wing to Moran, far side.
Well, screen to screen reaction. I'm not sure that was executed. Yeah, what Coach.
That's not what.
Yeah, Coach Simon didn't look pleased right now.
Graham Middleton, far side corner to Landon Hill. On the wing, Landon Hill pulls up for three, no good. Rebound number three, Austin Cluck.
That was like the UCA Bears in the 90s right there.
Yeah.
Somebody just jack it up. Here we go.
That shot up and good for CJ Mann.
Hand down, man down. A guy can stroke it.
Five coaches,
kid.
Guys.
34-29. Timeout called. Coach Jeremy Simon and the Valonia Eagles.
I mean, one kid.
As CJ Mann starts to cut into the lead of the Valonia Eagles.
It's a CJ Mann show. He's got 21 points. He's got 21 of their 29. I mean, you stop him, you stop Alma.
Absolutely. That's it. We saw that at Valonia. Same deal, Coach Simon, good timeout, kind of slowed the momentum down. He's got two timeouts left. I think this is a 30-second right here. enough time to talk about the 75% off sale.
Yes.
Going on at Linda
Marie's.
I'll
be there tomorrow.
Are you going to be there?
Yes.
Like guarding the door?
They'll probably need security.
Really? Dang, I didn't come watch that. I got a birthday party to go to, so
hey,
I can't miss that.
You know, you talked about Austin Myers earlier. Did you see the picture of Troy Myers holding the Lombardi Trophy?
I did not see that, really.
It was so awesome.
I saw it on the plane. Yeah.
He flew the Kansas City Chiefs back.
Oh, really?
A picture holding the Holy Grail of the Lombardi Trophy.
Of all trophies, right next to the NBA trophy. Football's awesome and all, but come on now, it's hoops. That is cool, though. No doubt. Man-to-man full court.
Tyler Moran handling the ball, gets it poked away by DJ George, picks it back up himself. Tyler Moran working on Georgia. George still trying to draw those fouls. And they'll call a double dribble or a carry,
Trapped on his hip right there. Tough break. A little bit of contact. Now, if you're dealing with a guy that's got two first names guarding you man-to-man, you gotta tread lightly right there. Good job by Timo keeping his emotions under control.
Hey, and girls basketball news. Greenwood beat Little Rock Christian 58-53.
What a game. At Little Rock?
No, that one was at Greenwood. Because Greenwood beat Little Rock Christian, or almost beat them at Little Rock Christian last time. They were without their coach.
Great hustle by
Greenwood. LT. Yeah, it was at Greenwood.
What a huge game that's going to be, Valonia.
No doubt.
Man. When is that? A few weeks, isn't it?
Yep, you're asking a group that's not going to give you much help on that one. Sorry.
Tyler Moran, far side corner, pulls up for three. No good.
Oh, good board.
Austin Myers nearly got the rebound, taken away by the Alma Airedales. DJ George now on the break. CJ Mann handling the ball for Airedales. He gives number three, Austin Cluck, who throws one up, but no good. It's going to bounce out of bounds. Last touch by number five, Bobby Winfrey.
If Mann could get some help, I mean, they would have a decent
team.
That's
true.
I mean, it's no help.
Grant Middleton driving off the quick pass up. No good.
I like that take,
rebound,
though.
Rebound, number five, Bobby Winfrey.
Get to the rim.
DJ George working on Myers, gets by him. CJ Mann now goes up from the top of the key, and it's going to go.
The kid doesn't miss.
Yeah. CJ Mann single-handedly has brought the Alma Airedales to within 2 points.
I think his real dad is either Al Dillard or Cannon Whitby.
Landon Hill up and good.
See, I don't think they have anything for us down low. They just can't. We're too strong. But if he keeps hitting all those threes, I mean, he's wide open.
CJ Mann near side corner, and it's going to go for CJ Mann.
That's just a little flick of the wrist, too. I mean, it's like a Dale Curry.
Got to find him. Got to find him. I don't know if we're playing a zone or playing a man.
That's why you got to love Tyler. You know, you think about what he does night in, night out. You know, he's not only our go-to guy a lot of times on offense, but he's always guarding the toughest of the tough.
He's
matched up against this guy.
He's got 27 points.
And he's just unconscious right now.
27 points.
And he's got the high top fade like he's going straight to the Marines after this game tonight.
He may be.
He's a hooper. Guys, timeout on the floor. Coach Simon down to one timeout, 1 point in the ball game. Big shout-out to our conference game sponsor of the night, Linda Marie's. Big shout out to all of our sponsors, actually. The Valonia Eagle Basketball Foundation is proud of each and every one of them. Couldn't bring this broadcast to you without the sponsorship.
No.
Thanks for supporting all the student athletes.
I mean, what's Coach Simon, what do you think he's drawing up right now? He's like, fine, 13. I don't care if anybody else shoots it.
Yeah.
He does not shoot the ball.
I think you have to. I mean, if he goes to the men's room, you follow him.
That's right.
Somebody just cranked up the radio here.
And you got kids dancing. Look at that. Look at that, Chris.
That's what move is that?
That is Grant. You back in the day. That's what that is.
His head's not quite big enough. But, yeah, I had a move like that.
Landon Hill handling the ball for the Eagles. 1 point ball game. Valonia above Alma.
Nice ball screen. I like this.
Tyler Moran.
I like the movement.
To Myers. Myers passed up the open three-pointer.
We should be able to get something out of this.
Austin Myers hands off to Landon Hill, who's going to drive, find Kuntz far side corner. Myers now near side wing, gets it inside to Wader. Austin Wader to Landon Hill, back out to Kuntz for three far corner. No. Rebound CJ Mann, and they'll call a foul on number 32, Austin Wader, Myers.
Just his first one. First team foul for either team, it looks like. That just shows you. I mean, we've been in some games this year where there's been 40 plus fouls throughout a 32 minute ball game. Right now, we got one team foul.
DJ George driving, stops, pulled back up, gets out to Austin Cluck for three, no good. Rebound Coons. No call, a foul on the Alma Airedales. Give to number 24, Nathan Whalen, positioning foul.
There you go. Make somebody else shoot the ball.
Absolutely.
Get it out of 13's hands.
Good box out by Myers right there.
Landon Hill working on C.J. Mann. Full court press by the Alma Airedales. Landon Hill breaks the press, loses the ball. Picked up by number 3, Austin Cluck, and they'll call a foul on Landon Hill.
And they could have called something early. Not Timo, but LT. Looks like he got a little bump right there. No call. Definitely a frustration foul. I can't blame him. Just his first foul, though, I believe.
C.J. Mann handling the ball now for Alma Airedales. Devin Wood, top of the key, gets his pass poked away. Picked up by Austin Wader. Now Kuntz on the break, goes up, loses it. And it's going to bounce out of bounds, poked away by C.J. Mann.
We got a ball game here, gentlemen.
Austin Kuntz came down just a little bit too far with the basketball.
We got to wake up.
And there's an Alma Airedale behind us. There's a real dog. Wow. Austin Myers loses the ball, gets pushed around, picked up by Alma Airedales. C.J. Mann gets D.J. George. That's number 20, Devin Wood, for three near side corner. No good. Rebound Myers. Austin Myers now across the timeline. Find Landon Hill. Landon Hill driving, puts it up and in for two.
And Landon's going strong all night, guys.
No doubt.
Going
strong.
Strong to the basket.
I think some lady just threw a rotator cuff out trying to throw the travel sign across the
field. Oh, my goodness.
C.J. Mann just throws it up and it falls.
That's unbelievable.
Is that C.J. Mann or Hunter Neely?
He's got 30 points, guys. 30 of the 38.
Tyler Moran working on D.J. George. Now it's Austin Kuntz on the far side wing. Kuntz driving, goes up.
Oh, nice move.
Oh, good.
Sam, I think you said it earlier, that the double team coming to AK every time he drives. AK starting to feel that.
Yeah.
But, you know, that tells us right now that AK 1-3 is at the top of that marker board.
Oh, yeah.
And so they know exactly where he's at.
Well, they're saying make somebody else beat
us. That's right.
And he's been beating a lot of teams on his own. And so.
Nice play.
Same thing with 13. Quit. Don't let him beat you.
We'll catch Austin Wader with a travel that time. And sloppy basketball is what's got the Eagles in trouble right now.
I tell you
that
what.
That and C.J. Mann.
C.J. Mann has definitely got a lot to do with it. I'll have to see Wader stop right there and knock a little baby hook down. He's got that shot in his repertoire.
So we've switched, and now Moran's not on him. Now we've got Kuntz on him.
Yeah, that's the downside of putting Timo on your best player, especially when he's scoring. It's hard to do both.
C.J. Mann throws up a three-pointer, and it goes from the near side corner.
Dude, you can't
and
miss.
Austin Kuntz looks like he got poked in the eye.
Yeah,
how do you can't stop that.
You only hope to contain him.
That's unbelievable.
So now I'm kind of glad I wore my green pants. Sorry. Did I say that on the air? That was an accident. Look at me like that. Good
Tyler
job.
Moran handling the ball now for the Eagles. Moving quickly across half court line. Pulls back out and give to Austin Myers. Landon Hill near side.
Man and man from Alma. You see C.J. He's all over Moran right now.
He's double-teaming him.
Kuntz spinning, goes up,
nice
is fouled.
There goes the double
And he
team.
Did get hit in the face again as he goes to the ground.
That's a good hard foul right there by Alma. You can definitely tell Coach Flanor has coached these guys up to know where 1-3 is at for sure.
Yeah.
Great move by A.K.
First free throw up and good for Austin Kuntz.
He's a trooper. That was a hard foul. He still bounced up somehow. First points of the night. Yeah, first points of the night, right?
Wow.
Attaboy.
Second free throw falls. C.J. Mann has 33 points. Tyler Moran the leading scorer for the Eagles has 14.
Just stop him. Just get on him. Now we went to a new guy.
I like this matchup. LT is.
We got Hill on him. Yep. Hill's not going to let him get away.
Number three, Austin Kluck has the ball now. He gets C.J. Mann, who wanted to throw it up right there. C.J. Mann gets to Kluck, who has Koontz on him. Austin Kluck moving around, gets to 20. Devin Wood finds inside 24. That's Nathan Whalen who laid it up and in.
That's good basketball right there, I will admit.
Austin Koontz near side gets to Moran, top of the key. Tyler Moran.
Coach, time bringing the play in, guys. Less than a minute here in the quarter.
Tyler Moran gets poked around by C.J. Mann, and they will call a foul on Mann.
Well, he's in the zone, guys. He's playing with the edge right now. See our guys respond.
It's his second foul, guys, not in foul trouble.
Landon Hill loses the ball as he tried to pass it. On the break are the Airedales. Whalen's got it. He puts it up. No good. Foul called. They'll give it to Austin Wader. Austin Wader now has four fouls and will likely be pulled out of the game as it's the third quarter with 43.9 seconds left.
Right now you got some tired bodies out there, yeah. And we really got to get some fresh legs in there, and we really need to have our starters get a little bit of a break to get some fresh legs to come back and fight in this fourth quarter.
And right now is a good opportunity to rest some of these guys, and where you're playing with four, got to be careful right here.
Neither free throw falls
for
the Alma Airedales, and credit that to one Bryce Myers on the opposite end, being the student section.
Nice work, son.
Austin Kukes finds Wader. Wader couldn't crowd the pass, spins, goes up, and was fouled. Number 15,
Martin Dyer. Well, that was beautiful right there. AK dropped him a dime. Yeah. Wader couldn't handle it right there, but good idea. Wader could knock these down.
He gave that foul to number 20, Devin Wood, his third. Scores 43-40 with 32.1 seconds left in the third quarter. It's the first free throw falls for Austin Wader.
A lot of time left here.
My clock got away from me. There's 32 seconds left. I have 17. That's okay. I'm going to let it hold for a minute.
I like the boxing one. I mean, it's what you got to do.
Yeah.
Good adjustment by Coach Simon. Yep.
He walked.
Travel call on number zero, Dax Staler. Right now, BB and Siloam Springs are playing. BB is up 53-41.
Wow.
Russellville beat Greenbrier 95-71.
12 seconds on the clock right here.
6 seconds. Myers has the ball. Nice finds look. Middleton. Middleton pulls up for three and gets it to go.
Big
Graham
shot.
Middleton far corner
big
for
shot.
Three. Alma that is now down 43-44 at the end of the third quarter. Eagles up by one.
And guys, hopefully we survive their biggest run of the night right there.
How many more shots can?
Yeah, exactly.
Can man?
I don't want to find. I don't want to find out. I don't want to find out.
I want a can man.
Now, fan feedback. Someone says CJ had 40 the other night against Greenwood.
He had 40 against Greenwood.
CJ.
Wow.
How did they spell it? Did they spell it right? How'd they spell CJ?
C. J.
See, you got it
wrong.
Right.
That's an X.
Oh. What is it?
Survey says it's spelled out. C-E-E-J-A-Y.
No, it's one E. One
no.
E.
No,
yes.
they got that wrong. It's a typo. I want it spelled with two E's, Grant.
You want it spelled. There's the dog. There's the dog, everybody.
I want a bivowel. Yeah, it is spelled out, though. C-E-J-A-Y. One E. But, yeah, 40. That's impressive. Kid's a ball player. Coach Simon made the right adjustment, guys. I mean, going boxing one with Landon, his quickness, his length. His tenacity. See how it plays out in the fourth quarter. Hey, breaking the action. Another shout out to our conference game sponsor tonight, Linda Marie's. Go check them out tomorrow. They got a 75% sale going on all day tomorrow right there on the bypass in South Mount Olive. There in the shopping center.
And it's not only Linda Marie's. You've also got
Charlie's Corner. Featuring Charlie's Corner. Absolutely.
The men's store.
Big shout out to all of our sponsors, but tonight's conference game sponsor, Linda Marie's. Here we go.
C.J. Mann handling the ball for the Alma Airedales. He's got Landon Hill on him defensively. Dax Taylor gets it inside to Whalen, who puts it up and in for two.
Baby hook.
Tyler Moran now handling the ball for the Eagles. He's got C.J. Mann on him defensively. Landon Hill now driving, gets to Ostmeyer's near side. Myers spinning
nice
up.
Move.
And in, and one opportunity for Austin Myers.
Good job.
The man with the
tan.
Yeah.
Bebo DB3 says, send man some Brahms, dot, dot, dot.
I just got to say, I'm disappointed in you guys. We had an over and under going, and I'm going to lose terribly.
Listen, I got a copyright infringement letter in the mail. I think they're looking for Sam. It wasn't me. It was from attorneys at Brahms. I can't.
Cease and assist?
Yeah.
That free throw no good for Myers. Rebound to Alma. C.J. Mann now handling the ball.
We are in Brahm country, guys. I mean.
This is where they grow the cows.
I can't speak to any of that. I just know where I'm going after this game.
We were there before.
Where are you going?
Where do you think I'm going?
I don't know.
I'm going to shut that place down.
Austin Cluck. Now it's C.J. Mann handling the ball. Nice pass to Dax Taylor, who drives along the baseline. Finds Winfrey. Right back to Staler near side corner. Staler up. No good. Rebound Graham Middleton.
Good job by Graham. Not to foul. Corral the board.
Yeah, it was good.
Got numbers.
Austin Kuntz gives to Middleton near side wing. Now Landon Hill on the near side. Landon Hill driving, gives to Myers. Far side wing for three, no. Rebound, number five, Bobby Winfrey.
1 point game, guys. I don't like it like this.
Dax Taylor loses the ball. Poked away and stolen by Moran.
Gosh.
They'll call a double dribble on Tyler Moran. Moran thought he got it poked away, as did Coach Jeremy Simon.
Good job by Timo right there, keeping his composure. Ask the ref what the situation was. There's all kinds of action right there.
No, what happened, Tyler Moran never dribbled it, really. He just picked it up off the ground, and they called a double dribble. They thought he dribbled it before. He did.
Another board from AK.
And guys, if we win this game, it's going to be because of the adjustments with the defense.
Absolutely.
Tyler Moran driving, spins around, finds Middleton far side corner. Grant Middleton will give to Landon Hill up top.
There's defense by committee against CJ. You have to do it. And Sam, you said it a couple times. You know, let's make somebody else beat us.
Yes, and so far they're 0-0.
I said fake.
Tyler Moran wide open for three. Gets it to go from the top of the key. Tyler Moran leading the Eagles.
17. Good job by AK, making that extra pass, getting another assist.
Yeah, C.J. Mann throws up another three. No good. Off the back iron. Yeah. Rebound. Bobby Winfrey, who was fouled by Tyler Moran.
Just his first foul.
Hey, but
fourth
look,
team.
They made him take a – I mean, if that ball was going in, I was just like, this is his night. His night.
Yeah, good adjustment putting Landon on there. Got the right amount of length.
Yep.
Tenacity. Good timeout by Coach Flinter. See what he draws up here. Got a full timeout. Alma's down to four timeouts, right down to three, I'm sorry. And then Bologna's got the one left, of course. Looks like Alma has 16 fouls, though. The Eagles will be in the bonus next foul.
Yeah, and I think we need to try to get back down low. I mean, yeah, we're being patient. Got a good look there by Moran on the three-pointer. But, hey, let's – I don't know. It's a two-edged sword. You don't want the clock to stop either. You know, it just gives them more opportunities.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, get a good high percentage look right here. I do like getting the ball into the low block, like you're saying, maybe even the high post. Good job by the guys catching the ball in the corner, driving into the paint, and kicking the ball back out for an open jump shot.
Yeah,
a lot of time left here. Let's see what kind of adjustments we got. And I'm pretty sure that's Ozzie on the PA system. So Alma.
Crazy train that
I don't know if I think my younger self would give them a plus one, but my older self is saying that's a minus one. I'm sure I like that. Hey, coach.
Yeah.
Hey, we are listening to out there, guys.
That's awesome right there, man.
Dax Taylor throws up a three, no good. Rebound, number three, Austin Cluck.
We just had the head coach of the Alma Lady Airedales come up here and clarify our misspelling of his son's name. That was awesome.
Well, I spelled it right. That two is up and good.
Oh, that's
number
great.
Five, Bobby Winfrey.
Love it.
I'm sorry, Chris. You know I love
you. I threw you under the bus. I said, listen, this kid over here is trying to spell it wrong with two E's.
So that is his dad. That's his dad.
That's his dad, yeah.
Wow. Look
just like
he's
him.
He's a young man.
He is. Yeah.
That could go for his brother almost. Yeah. He's young looking.
He might sub in there a second. Might want to keep an eye on him.
Yeah, let's watch out. Don't need two mans out there. One man's enough.
Oh, that was cool, though.
Does that mean we have Alma fans listening to us?
Listen,
we have somebody watching, listening. I mean, I kind of feel special right now.
Yeah, absolutely. It's the attorneys from Brahms, I'm pretty sure.
I expect when I go through the drive-thru at Brahms, they're going to say, Sam Jansky, anything on the house for you, son.
Oh, my goodness.
Are we getting closer?
Confetti's just going to come flying out of the drive-thru window.
Are we close? Are we close to the over-under?
Both free throws fell for Austin Kuhn. C.J. Mann handling the ball now.
I think we're out of the box in one. Maybe back in – no, here it is. No. I like it.
Stay steady.
D.J. George gets it across the way to Dax Taylor. Now it's number three, Cluck.
They're not letting
George head fakes, drives, goes, and was fouled by Tyler Moran on the drive.
That was petty.
Tyler Moran reached around. No column with a touch foul.
I don't know if that was a foul. That's his second foul. He's okay.
Score is 51-47. Eagles up. Bobby Winfrey gets it inside to George. He finds Cluck near side corner for three. Wide open, no good. Rebound Landon Hill gets to Tyler Moran as Landon Hill was fouled by Bobby Winfrey.
Yeah. Hey, look, so far, great move. They cannot. Yep. Nobody else can make a shot right now. I hope I didn't jinx that.
Yeah.
But nobody else can make a shot right now unless
that's
it's right
adjustment.
In front of the rim.
Yeah, he was so hot we had to do something, and Coach Simon made that move.
33 points.
First free throw up and good. And I love that. I love that. I'm sorry that he's not from Valonia, but I love that.
That's a nice attire he has on.
I like it.
Second free throw up and good.
And it faced him. It faced LT. My clock keeps sticking. I don't know what's going on with my clock.
I had that problem the other night, too.
It was sticking. I look down, and it's, like, stuck, and I look, and it's, like, 20 seconds evaporate.
DJ George, far side, gets to Cluck. Cluck pulls up for two. Yes, it will roll around and in.
Barely.
For Austin Cluck. Tyler Moran. Handling the ball now for the Filoni Eagles. Important info. Bronx closes at 10:45. Austin Kuntz down low. Yeah. Up. No.
Can't find
rebound 24, Nathan Whalen.
Yep. Not finding the angle.
C.J. Mann handling the ball now for Alma. Wanted to pull up. Didn't. He'll get to D.J. George. Now it's Dax Taylor. Taylor, his pass.
What was that?
They'll call a foul
white
on Alma.
Three. White three.
Yeah, I think Timo's shooting. Timo's our shooter.
They'll give it a 1-1 to Tyler Moran. I think they called it against number three.
I think you're right.
Yep.
They'll give it to Austin Cluck. First free throw for Moran, up and in.
Big shot right there. These 1-on-1s are huge. 18 for Timo.
Second one up and in as well.
Two possession ball game, guys. Stay on man.
DJ George. To Dax Taylor on the near side. Whalen gets it down low to Austin. Cluck for two.
I should have kept my mouth shut because things were going good until I mentioned the obvious.
That's what everybody's saying on live fan feedback too, Sam.
Captain,
that's what we're saying.
Captain Obvious. Thanks, Captain Obvious. Okay, well.
A lot of time left here. Still got a
lot of time.
4-point lead. Surprised Coach Flanor hasn't, or Flynn or whatever it is. I'm surprised that he hasn't started running him off some double screens or some ball screens or some. Right now, 13 man's pretty much on his own. Old-fashioned three-point play.
That free throw up and good for Austin Kluck.
Oh.
Landon Hill's pass poked away as Mann goes up, no good. Rebound, George, blocked by Graham Middleton.
Block.
And Landon Hill got the rebound. They'll call Austin Kuntz with the travel.
No.
Austin Kuntz can't believe it. Alma excited.
Guys, I got us down for 11 turnovers.
Yeah. Yeah, turnovers will lose the ball game for you.
Three-point ball game.
Nice score,
55-52. Alma Airedale's handling the ball now. C.J. Mann. We'll give to D.J. George, now Dax Taylor. Austin Kluck working on Myers. Kluck goes around, floats it up. No good, but he was fouled. He's going to go to the line to shoot two.
I don't like all these touch fouls they're calling right now. On one side of the, you know.
That's the seventh one on Bologna, so now Alma will be in the one-on-one. This is a two-shot foul. That's three on Myers. Now look at the board. I showed that Waiters only got three fouls on him right now. I hope that's right.
I believe our shooter has some blood on his knee. He does.
You can see it.
Yeah, both of his knees look jacked up.
That was a little bit mean there, Chris.
I feel his pain. I tried to ride a skateboard one time on the way to the dentist. I looked about like that.
He's going to the locker room.
I was 11.
We'll just wait here.
Can they do that?
I mean, they have to. He is the shooter.
Don't you have to pull somebody off your bench if they can't shoot?
Where did he just go?
He went to the locker room.
No, you know where he went.
To Bronx.
You know he went to Bronx.
There you go.
Hey, welcome back, son.
Wow.
Glad to see you.
He put a tourniquet on. I think
they had to give a timeout. So I think they gave him a couple seconds and said if he's not back in this amount of time, it's a timeout.
He came out of the tunnel.
Like
him
take one.
He's shooting out of the tunnel.
He was fired out of a cannon. You know where he could have gone if he was at Bologna is Bologna Family Pharmacy.
They have
all of the ointments and the
they could have managed that right
off. Oh, man, yeah. Right there. While he's shooting.
You know what else he could have got while he's there? Some flyers for his mom.
Yeah. Man, next Friday, that's the place
that's
to
right.
shop. That's the place to shop right there. Bologna
no
Family
doubt.
Pharmacy.
I bet,
no doubt about it.
I bet they're getting orders left and right now.
And they have a drive-thru.
For flowers?
It's great. Yes. Potentially, definitely, maybe.
Do they deliver? That's the question.
Another one of our sponsors does, though. Pizza Pro and Bologna has started delivering. And how else can we talk about some of our sponsors? That's a pretty good little segment.
Yeah,
right
it
there.
Was good. He could go over there and get a order of pizza while he's waiting on the prescription.
There you go, exactly. That's it.
First free throw up and good for Austin Kluck. 2-point ball game. Chance to make it one now. Second free throw is good. 1-point ball game. 55-54. Austin Myers gives to Tyler Moran.
Man-to-man full court, y'all. What a game.
Tyler Moran handling the ball for the Eagles. Gets Austin Kuntz near side. Now Waiter down low. Austin Waiter puts it up and in.
Where was the end one there?
Yeah.
He got bumped on the way up. Stay on man.
D.J. George handling the ball. Top of the key. Works around to the near side. George gets to Staler, who loses the ball. It bounces out of bounds to Teal basketball.
I say we run our two-minute offense.
Yeah, absolutely. Coach Simon's got one timeout left right here. He said something to the ref. Maybe saying if we get in trouble, keep an eye on me, or I don't know, something. Some smart coaching stuff.
Yep.
Austin Myers, far side. Gets Tyler Moran up top. Tyler Moran working on D.J. George. Got a screen from Waiter. Now Myers has the ball. Myers driving, throws it up. And they'll call a charge on Austin Myers, who goes down painfully.
I don't know how that was a charge. The guy wasn't even set. He's running with him. How is that? I don't understand it. Well, you're on the road, boys.
Yeah, absolutely. Got to play through it. Short memory.
That's some Brahms cooking right there.
Down low and in, and one opportunity is Bobby Winfrey.
I'm sorry, guys, but this ref down there is a foul calling machine. The guy on the baseline just called the charge, just called that foul. I think he lives over here at Eagle Crest.
I just know I learned my lesson.
Tea time at 8 o'clock in the morning.
You'll see him here in the next 7 days. That's what happened to me, Sam. I said something bad about a ref, and I see him at the game. Like, I'm sitting next to him. He's like, hey, aren't you the one?
Where's that Chris Lee at? I don't talk to him.
That wasn't me. That was that Chris Lee fellow you're thinking of.
Exactly.
Awesome. Side wing gets Tyler Moran, who puts it up and in, and one opportunity for Tyler Moran.
And you got to call that no matter what because he's inside the circle that's
too
not
deep.
There.
Yeah.
Too deep.
What a game Moran's had tonight.
And I don't think that was a call play. I just think there was a slight breakdown. Those two guys that played together long enough.
Great
job by those guys.
I agree.
Good two-man game.
Tyler Moran has 21 points with a chance to make it 22, and he will.
Scores
60-56.
We've seen that play in Coach Simon's repertoire. It may have been drawn up, but in that moment, that was just a great read by two seniors.
Clovis Satterfield claims to be an Alma fan. We love that you're here. Maybe we
can
convert you.
Now, let's hold the ball. Let's hold it. We got a good man tried to get a waiter with the foul there.
Tyler Moran handling the ball now, working on DJ George. Tyler Moran still has the ball. Hands it off to Austin Myers, a sophomore, and they'll call a timeout for Coach Jeremy Simon and the Vilone Eagles.
Yep, good timeout. Last one,
yep.
Hey, you know what? You guys will feel like $1 million if you go to any of our sponsors to do business. And Steve.
Yes.
You know it was worth $1 million?
Gold.
Yeah.
No, the opportunity to see Houston Nutt at the football banquet.
Absolutely. What a night that was. I mean, a shout out to the Vilone Eagle Football Foundation for putting that on. Centennial Bank for sponsoring. It was a fabulous night. Not only did we have a dynamic speaker that encouraged the players, you had the team getting awards for what they've done on the football field this year. All state, all conference. We had the Jerry Roberts Leadership Award given out.
Absolutely.
Just a wonderful, wonderful night.
You know, it was like to be there, I felt like a 16-year-old, so me, in a candy store. That's what it was like.
You know, I had the privilege of escorting Houston around, kind of being his bodyguard, I guess you would say, security. And to listen to him and the general.
Yes.
From when.
Yeah.
Sitting at the same table and listening to them talk was just awesome.
That would be awesome.
He probably knows the general, does he?
Oh, he does, yes.
He probably had some guys he recruited from the general back in the day.
Austin Myers handling the ball now for the Eagles. Austin Myers getting pushed around a little bit by Saylor.
Yep.
Now Landon Hill has it. Landon Hill working on C.J. Mann. Tyler Moran up top has DJ George. Now Kuntz working on Austin Cluck. Eagles trying to chew clock with a 4-point lead right now.
Double bonus, too.
They're going to have to foul.
Kuntz was fouled by number 3, Austin Cluck. That's his third.
We just wasted 30 seconds, guys, off the clock, and we have a good free throw shooter at the line.
Good timeout right there by Coach Simon. Calm everybody down. Tell them to burn some time. Just over a minute left.
Kuntz's first free throw up and good.
Kuntz with
5 points off the line.
5 points for the night. I mean, when was the last time he was held to single digits?
Oh, it's a free throw line. I think it was in the Pee Wee finals in sixth grade.
Maybe in kindergarten, maybe?
Yep.
Yeah.
Second free throw up and good for Austin Kuntz. 6-point ball game. DJ George driving, throws it up, no good, and they'll call a foul on Austin Wader, it looks like. Yes.
Fourth?
That's his fourth.
Okay.
DJ George will be sent to the line to shoot two. Graham Middleton is going to check in for the Vilone Eagles after this first free throw. First one's up and good for George. Middleton checks in. Wader checks out. Eagles won't lose too much size. Second free throw up and good. Four-point ball game.
Take care of the basketball right here. You're shooting two free throws with every foul. Just take care of the ball.
50 seconds left. Tyler Moran handling the ball. As Austin Cluck came out and fouled Tyler Moran. Austin Cluck now has four fouls.
Guys, just, you know, take care of it at the line.
Yep,
and
absolutely.
Hey, you know, try to get out of here with a big W. I mean, a win's a win. It didn't matter. It didn't matter what the score is.
First free throw, no good for Moran off the front of the rim.
Every game on the road is a hard, tough battle. You better be ready to come play every night at somebody else's house.
Second free throw up, no good.
Man. And he looked like he wasn't bending his knees there. He looked a little just straight-legged.
Can't find CJ.
Austin Cluck working around, driving, makes a move, lays it up and in. Two-point ball game, timeout called.
Goodness.
What a game, guys. Got a full timeout on the floor right here. Give another big shout-out to our conference game sponsor of the night, Linda Marie's, featuring Charlie's Corner. Check them out tomorrow. 75% sale on certain items right there on the bypass in South Mount Olive in the Valonia Commons Shopping Center. So definitely check them out. They do a lot for all of our programs, whether it be football, basketball, baseball, softball, track, and other things other than just sports too. So big shout-out to them. Definitely check them out at Linda Marie's. So much more than, you know, just fabrics and just clothes. There's candles. There's stuff for men. That doesn't necessarily go together, stuff for men and candles, but it does. Misty brings home candles. I love them. They're great.
I've seen you pictures with candles.
Absolutely.
are they happy candles?
They are happy candles. Absolutely.
Go with the happy coffee.
Go with the happy coffee. Yeah. Misty can tell you all about it. Yeah. All right, guys, here we go. 37 seconds left. I mean, whoever's running the music here at Alma, I think they work at the skating rink, Beaver T Skateland in Heber Springs back in 92. Now that's some AC/DC and some Ozzy back to back.
I love it. Now some Queen.
Tyler Moran now for the Eagles. 30 seconds left on the clock. Tyler Moran crossing over, gets by CJ Mann, DJ George.
Nice
and
look.
Austin Kutas wide open, down low for two. Eagles stretch the lead to four.
Great look. 20 seconds left. Let's hope they miss this.
CJ Mann throws up a three.
No way.
No way.
Are you kidding me?
An incredible shot with 14 seconds left exactly.
Listen, I'm picking him on 2K. Like, can I create a player? If I can, it's CJ Mann.
That is unbelievable.
He walked up there like he knew he was about to hit it.
36 points.
He knew he was about to hit it. He's a ball player. You can't say enough about what Landon's done this second half.
One man show.
Landon has shut him down.
Guys, he pulled up at that white volleyball line.
I mean, he did.
I was like, there ain't no way this is going in.
Stop and pop from 35 feet away.
Got an Airedale dog in the building.
That's a real dog.
Where's
good,
it at?
Good looking dog right there.
Where? I don't see it.
Where's right the over dog here. At? To our right.
Oh, yeah, sure enough. Is that the mascot?
I believe it is.
Here we go, gentlemen. 14 seconds left on the clock. Both teams in double bonus. Nobody has timeouts left. Only question I'd like to have answered is, do we get free basketball or not? I hope it's overtime. Hey. I'm always ready for overtime.
You know, Brahms closes at 10:45.
You know, I don't want overtime.
If there's anything that I would give up Brahms for, it would be overtime. I love free basketball.
I don't want it.
Austin Myers throws the ball, and Tyler Moran gets it back to Myers. Myers keeps it and is fouled by number zero, Dax Staler. 10 seconds left exactly, 64-63. Austin Myers being sent to the line to shoot two free throws.
Let me ask this. If he was to make these two, do you foul immediately and don't let him even give an attempt at a three? Do you just foul him?
He could. Yeah, put him in the line.
I don't think you do, just because you want as much clock to run off as possible.
If you foul him, you wait
till as soon as they get down there.
Yeah, never mind. Man. Never mind now, because that didn't go in.
You can't let CJ catch the ball. Easier said than done.
We better get out there, get ready, because he's shooting.
Yeah, you know where the ball's going.
Second free throw will fall for Austin Myers.
Anybody but this guy.
2-point ball game. C.J. Mann has the ball.
Hey, that's not
23
is
a shooter.
Called on Landon Hill, sending 23 D.J. George to the free throw line with 7.2 seconds left.
That's not a bad foul. That's not a bad foul. Think about it. This kid, 23, has 4 total points tonight. Okay.
He's got 2 first names, Sam. Let's just watch. I'm not sure.
I saw he looked a little
nervous. He's a wild card.
He looked a little nervous up there. He looked a little nervous.
First free throw up and good.
Boy.
I can't believe they actually called that, to be honest with you. I mean, I thought LT was just progressing through the play. Nobody called out screen. That's the first problem. And LT did not foul him. That's a tough break right there.
If somebody will yell out chicken nugget, that'll jinx him.
Second free throw up and good.
Oh,
rolling all around.
No, we're not.
7 seconds left. Tyler Moran has the ball. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Shoot.
Middleton throws it up.
Oh,
no.
My gosh. Hey, good look from Graham right there. We got overtime. Yes. It's past your curfew, Grant. It's okay, though. We got this. Woo.
Run Eagles at the end of regulation have a tie ball game, 65-65. 4 minutes are added to the clock for the overtime period.
Each team gets a timeout right now, I believe, going into this four-minute period. You know, you think Alma has the momentum, but in this situation, I'm going with the Eagles. We have guys that can get the job done inside, plus we got shooters. Eagles will have it right out of the tip. This overtime is brought to you by all of our platinum sponsors, Bologna Eagle Family Pharmacy, Sims Electric, GenWealth Financial, Ott Insurance, Central Arkansas Trophy. Of course, a conference game sponsor of the night, Linda Marie's, HSA Engineering. All of our platinum sponsors, big thank you for allowing us to bring this broadcast to you every Tuesday and Friday night. And guys, as we go up to the state tournament, man, this doesn't get much better than this. Free basketball.
Extra basketball tonight.
Yes.
The Nation of Bronx.
I'm in a full body sweat. This is good stuff. Sam's sweating right here next to me.
I am sweating, but I'm not.
Those socks look great, though.
I'm going to tell you, if we don't come out with a victory, that Brahms chocolate shake is going to suck.
Landon Hill
attaboy,
gets
LT.
The tip off right back. Austin Coots driving, puts it up, no good. Landon Hill, yes! Landon Hill got it to fall. 2-point ball game. C.J. Mann now for the Airedales.
He came down and landed hard and popped right back up there. What a play.
His head.
Only LT does that.
Austin Myers gets a steal. Landon Hill's on the break. Landon Hill up and in. And Landon Hill with the slam.
That's the way you start the overtime.
Just like that.
4-point ball game. Eagles in the driver's seat. C.J. Mann now for Alma. D.J. George has the ball. Pump fakes. Gives to Staler for three near side.
Wow.
It's going to go.
How can he see the rim? That's his first points of the game.
1-point ball game.
Rip Hamilton.
Tyler Moran working on D.J. George. Moran. Give to Coons. Coons couldn't corral it. Got it right back.
The back door.
Nope, not there.
Coach Flanor has seen that. He's coached him on that one.
Austin Coons gives to Landon Hill. Now Moran up top. Waiter on the far side.
Nice
now
cut.
Top of the key is Landon Hill.
We had a cut there.
Nice
look. Waiter down low, lays it up and in.
How about that?
What a play. Screen to screener. You got to love that.
Stay on him, LT. Get up in his grill.
3-point ball game. Austin Cluck has the ball. Gives D.J. George, who head fakes and finds Staler. Exact same spot for three, and it's going to go.
He had 0 points through the regulation.
Who is
unbelievable.
That kid? Who is that kid?
I think it's C.J. Mann's dad. Swapped out jerseys and mask.
He's got a mask, so they can identify him.
Who is this guy?
Landon Hill handling the ball for the Eagles. Gives to Austin Myers.
It's okay, guys. We're good.
Landon Hill, far side, driving on the baseline.
Oh,
up,
good
no good. Tried to get around.
Dang, good move.
The draw charge.
It's a high percentage shot. LT can hit those.
Tie ball game. C.J. Mann handling the ball. He's going to have Landon Hill on him defensively, who's likely going to get screened by Austin Cluck or D.J. George. C.J. Mann throws up a shot, and it falls.
Guys, that's just unreal.
Golly, unbelievable.
He's got 39.
Austin Coons driving, goes up.
How's
no. Rebound Coons. Coons loses it. It goes to
good
ground.
Hustle.
Jump ball call.
Great hustle. Surely somebody in the state of Arkansas is trying to get this C.J. Mann kid on their team.
What grade's he in?
Man, exactly. 13th?
Yeah.
Guys,
is he a senior?
Yes.
Man. I don't know what to say. Don't know what to say.
Three-point ball game, 74-71. Eagles down.
Foul.
Dax Staler.
You don't foul him.
As C.J. Mann, Dax Staler, back to C.J. Mann, top of the key. Alma moving the ball around quickly. D.J. George tried to get this. C.J. Mann, foul called on the Eagles.
Not a bad deal right there. LT's only got three fouls. That's his fourth. It looked clean from over here, of course. We're Valonia fans, and we're not objective, but, man, that's a good-looking steal. Ball looked like it popped out of there clean.
D.J. George's first free throw up and good.
This kid, he hit some pressure-packed free throws, no doubt about it.
Austin Waiter checks out. Graham Middleton checks in. D.J. George, second free throw up and good.
Wow.
Five-point ball game. Tyler Moran handling the ball for the Eagles. Moran gets inside, finds Middleton. Middleton back out to Moran for three near side. No. Rebound. Myers. Myers puts it up and in for two. Timeout call. Coach Jeremy Simon.
Going to set this press up right here, hopefully. Both teams in a double bonus. Wow. Got a little bit of foul trouble up there. LT's playing with four. Looks like Myers is playing with four. Graham's only got one. Timo's got two. On the other side, C.J. Mann's got two. Wish he had four. Number three has four. No major foul trouble on their side. But LT and Myers both are playing with four right here. Those guys can't foul on the inbound.
Yeah, you can't. I mean, there's a lot of time left. I mean,
oh, yeah. Eternity.
You don't have to have threes. You just get this.
That's a massive camera down there. They must be from 4029. Is that in that Northwest Arkansas or Fort Smith Channel?
Yeah.
Or maybe that's just the Alma regular camera.
I'm pretty sure that's just the Alma camera.
It's like straight Betamax right there. Impressive. Here we go, guys. Full court pressure.
Jansky's got Mann on his side.
Yep.
Looks like the Eagles are denying C.J. Mann. What? And a foul's called on Landon Hill immediately.
That's five on
and that's
him.
His fit. Landon Hill will be out of the game, and that's a big hit for the Eagles. Dax Staler will be sent to the line to shoot two, and it's a three-point ball game with 1:11 left.
They're not even letting him have an attempt at a steal. They're just saying, I know you're trying to foul.
That wasn't what we saw in the first half. I think it's our biggest problem. It wasn't consistent. They let him play throughout the entire game, and has a pretty quick whistle right there.
First free throw up, no good off the front of the rim for Dax Staler.
We know who to foul now.
This guy had 0 points.
He could shoot
at the
threes.
End of regulation, hit two threes.
Yeah, he can shoot threes.
The master man.
Second free throw for Dax Staler.
He looks
up and good.
He looks very
4-point ball game.
Go.
Tyler Moran handling the ball. Just over a minute left to play. Plenty of time. Austin Myers. Now Jansky on the near side. Jansky give to Middleton. Graham Middleton working around. Gives right back to Harrison Jansky. Jansky on the near side to Graham Middleton. Graham Middleton pulls up for three. No. Oh. Rebound, C.J. Mann.
That's a good two-man game right there. A little penetrate and kick it. Good-looking shot.
Double team in the full court by the Eagles, and Tyler Moran gets caught with a foul. D.J. George will be sent to the line by Tyler Moran as a blocking foul is called.
What a turn of events. Unbelievable.
At one point, the Eagles were up by double digits. C.J. Mann came out of nowhere and was lights out ever since. That free throw's no good.
And the box and one adjustment, guys, it was brilliant. I mean, that's what we had to do. But, you know, his teammates, the supporting cast, stepped up.
Second free throw up. No good. Rebound Jansky. Harrison Jansky now will give to Tyler Moran. 40 seconds left. Four-point game. Tyler Moran driving, goes up, finds Middleton, far side corner for three.
Oh,
yes! Graham Middleton gets it to fall. One-point ball game. Eagles need to foul. Laying it in. That's Bobby Winfrey for two.
Not bad, though. They got 2 points. Quick. We got the ball right back.
20 seconds left. 15 seconds left. Moran throws it up. No good. Rebound. Dax Staler, who is fouled by Kuntz.
Golly.
Austin Kuntz sends Dax Staler to the free throw line. Three-point ball game. 10.4 seconds left. The crowd is on its feet for Alma. Eagles in a hole with 10 seconds left to work with. And a man that has a chance to stretch it to a five-point lead. One free throw does about the same thing as two for Alma in this situation, and they won't get the first one, and that's the one they really needed.
Huge right here.
Second free throw for Dax Staler. It's up and good. Four-point game.
Quick three.
Tyler Moran going down, drives, puts it up, and he was fouled on the floor. They're going to say he wasn't yet going up before he was fouled.
That's right, though. Let's make one, and we've got to miss the second one on purpose.
And I'm not sure that you can call that. Just that entire move was part of him going up, so that's got to be a shooting foul, and he will be sent to line either way, though.
Yep.
I don't know why I'm bothered by it.
No, we got to miss this.
Exactly right. 5 seconds left, down by three. Making this shot doesn't do a whole lot for you unless you get the steal right off the inbound. Braden Lee checks in for Graham Middleton.
Not for sure what's...
Just need some size down there.
Yeah, you got...
Looks like everybody's going to be crashing the glass right here. Free throw up, no good. Eagles foul, 3.5 seconds left, sending number three Austin Kluck to the line, who has 11 points.
3.5 on the clock.
Graham Middleton will check back in for the Eagles. Two shots. Eagles need to miss both, and they need a miracle, likely from full court to half court range. First free throw is good.
Thought it was going to slip out, guys.
Yeah, tried to. Good minutes from Jansky right there, no doubt. That's classy. Warm up the bus. It is cold out. I mean, if I'm going to take that literally.
They let us know that.
Yeah, it is.
I think they said warm up Kluck.
No, clearly they didn't say that. I like your positive attitude, though.
Austin Myers throws up a prayer, won't fall. Five-point game. Eagles walk out of Alma with the first loss of the second half of conference play.
Man.
A surprise to many. Again, Alma, one of the stronger teams in the 5A West. Glenn, you really needed this win, however, to compete with Russellville for the number one spot. Looks like Ronnie's going to be playing for a number two or a number three spot in the playoffs now.
And the guys competed the whole game. I mean, you got to give it to them. They played hard. Coach Simon coached a good game.
Well, it all
Alma
comes
just
down,
stepped up.
It all comes down to man.
Yeah.
You couldn't stop him.
Yeah.
Four, I mean, 39 points.
Put up 39. And when he had that drought, when LT played such good defense on him, his team stepped up. You got to give it to Alma. Hate losing that one right there. That's a tough loss.
It's a tough loss, and we was really going to need a lot of help anyway to get that number one seed. But now, guys, we're looking at a two or, you know, the two or the three. And honestly, if you look at you want to do the best
three.
You can, right? But the three, it looks a lot better than two. If you're looking at matchups.
Yeah, coming out of the
east.
And
trying to go deep, right? Yep. So not to say we're trying to lose games to get that three spot, but – again, now, hey, you got to pick yourself back up and go, what went wrong? And, I mean, one guy was lights out tonight.
Yeah, he was.
What do you do
yeah.
with that, you know?
Yeah, no I mean, doubt.
You hate that one guy beat you like that, but, man, I mean, 40-point yep. game, 39-point yep. game.
Tip our hat to him.
Yeah.
No doubt.
Yeah.
Well-deserved win. Hey, we got the L right there, but the boys can't hang their heads. They played hard.
Yeah.
And left it all out on the court.
Hey, tough loss. I'm Grant McNew alongside Chris Lee, Sam Jansky, and Stone Cold Steve Austin. We'll see you next time around.